Hey mamas, Ayo here. In today's video, we go over some physical relaxation techniques that can really help when it comes to active labor and birth. So pull up a chair or have a sit on your mat. As always, make sure that you're cleared by your doctor for practice, and let's jump on in. Relaxation. Relaxation is a super good thing in life, and it's an even better thing when it comes to active labor and birth. The more that we're able to relax, the greater the ability for our body to open, the greater the ability for our contractions or pressure waves to do that work that it needs to do in bringing our baby one step closer to our arms. So today we'll be exploring a new technique for physical release and relaxation. And this was taught to me by one of my regular yoga students, who is also a doula and a massage therapist. Her name is Chaya Velier, and I will share her information in the description below. So what is it we're going to do today? We'll start out in a moment setting up our breath. You can be sitting on a mat, on a chair, really just being any place that's comfortable and releasing for you. You could even lay down if you'd like to do so. And after we set up our breath, we're going to start bringing our attention to a few different points in the body. And what we'll do is touch on each point one after another consecutively, in a way that just brings added and added waves of release. So that's the overview of what's about to happen. Now let's jump in and make it happen. Sitting or laying, wherever you are, you can rest your hands on your knees, on your thighs, on your tummy. And let's just draw a full deep breath in. And exhale, a complete release. And breathing deeply in. And releasing. And as you sit here, and as you breathe here, I would like you to bring your focus to your shoulders. Our shoulders, these are areas that tend to carry a lot of tightness and tension. Sometimes without even realizing it, we can kind of have our shoulders up by our ears or just even like drawn in an uncomfortable way. So the first thing we're gonna do, the first step, is to drop or release our shoulders. So if you can imagine your shoulders coming up toward your ears like you're wearing them like earrings, this is the opposite. We're releasing, letting shoulders be dropped and be heavy. And it doesn't matter if your shoulders are back or if your shoulders are forward. We're not doing ballet technique here. It's just a sense of release. So releasing your shoulders, let's take a full breath in and a full breath out, and already just feel that wave of release down our body with dropped shoulders. Now the second place we're going to release today is our cheeks. Sometimes people say, what does that mean, release our cheeks? Well, all the muscles that we use to make our facial expressions or to smile, let's just release those. Let those become soft, let those become heavy, feeling a wave of release down the face. Now, the third place that we're going to release as we continue to sit here breathing in and breathing out is our jaw. So what does that mean? It's going to look a little bit silly. If any of you are watching the video, you're welcome to just close your eyes and listen to the video. But it's kind of this almost guppy mouth of, or that you're totally surprised at something someone said. And literally our mouth is turning into an oval shape and our jaw, our chin is dropping. So jaw released, breathing in and breathing out. Now the fourth place is fingers. Taking full breath in, and with the exhale, just release fingers. And with fingers released, feeling a wave of release down the arms, of physical relaxation down the arms and the tips of your fingers. And lastly, with your next full breath in and full breath out, you can think about releasing your knees. Or for me, I found it a bit easier to connect with the idea of releasing my thighs. All of that tightness, that tension that maybe kind of gets sucked into the area of the hip flexors, release. So let's try those 5 points again. Full breath in and full breath out, releasing the shoulders, dropping the shoulders. And full breath in and out, releasing the cheeks. Full breath in and out, releasing the jaw. And full breath in and out, releasing the fingers. Full breath in and out, releasing the knees. Now you can already check in with, how are you feeling? Bringing awareness, release, relaxation to each of these 5 points. Is there any part of you that already feels a bit more physically calm and physically relaxed? And I hope the answer is yes. If not, stick with me. We're gonna try this a few more times. Now, generally what's done is of these 5 points, we choose 4 to work on. There's something about a rhythm of 4 that kind of connects to our body. It's almost a sort of musicality of the 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll choose shoulders. Shoulders are a really important area. And then you can choose 3 of the other ones. So again, the choices were cheeks, jaw, fingers, and knees. And I'll probably cue today the cheeks, the jaw, and the fingers. You can choose whatever feels right for you. Or let's see. Actually, I'm gonna cue jaw, fingers, knees. Yeah, there we go. So let's try that again, just one round with the 4 you chose. So full breath in and full breath out, release shoulders. And full breath in and out, release jaw. Full breath in and out, release fingers. And full breath in and out, release knees, or that whole area between the hips and the knees, the thighs. And what we'll do, the more that you practice any technique, the more it becomes a part of you, the more natural it feels. And so perhaps it's easy to access a state and a place of physical release in the comfort of your own home. But we want to also prepare ourselves to access this place when we're in slightly less comfortable situations. So I'll take us through maybe 4 or 5 examples. But sitting here, laying here with eyes closed, I invite you to visualize, to see, to think about early labor at home. The feeling of those first contractions coming, of, oh my gosh, it's starting and it's really happening. And maybe with it come thoughts of, did I finish packing my bag for the hospital or the birthing center? Or did I finish this project I'm working on? Or whatever it is. But when you think about, when you visualize that early labor at home, and that dawning that this is real and this is going down. Let's respond to that feeling with full breath in and exhale, release shoulders. And full breath in and exhale, release jaw. Full breath in and exhale, release fingers. And full breath in and exhale, release knees, hips. Feeling that sense of calm, of physical release, and of opening. And each of these areas, specifically for birth, are very, very powerful to helping us open and release the area of the cervix, which is the space inside us that needs to widen in order for the baby to come out. Especially when we release the jaw, there's this idea of a correspondence between the jaw and this area of the cervix of just opening and release. So let's let's continue on in our labor, in our birthing. For those of you not birthing at home, those of you who will be at a birthing center or a hospital, there's that transition of getting into the car. Maybe you're transitioning from early labor to more active labor, and you need to go from the comfort of your own home or birthing ball or whatever you're using to this kind of more cramped and closed space, and maybe surrounded in close proximity with a person or people. And it's just this shift in environment. So visualizing yourself there, let's touch on these same four rhythmic points. Breathing in. And exhale, release the shoulders drop. And breathing in. And exhale, release the jaw. Breathing in. And exhale, release the fingers. And breathing in. And exhale, release the knees and hips. Feeling that sense of openness, of calm, of relaxation, checking in with yourself to see how you feel. We'll take a third situation. We're continuing on with our birth and about to exit the car as we see ourselves approaching the hospital or the birthing center. And that transition of first seeing that hospital or center and preparing yourself to step out of the car. And maybe those things bring with it a wave of trepidation or fear or constriction. And responding to that, full breath in. And exhale, drop the shoulders, release. And full breath in. And exhale, release the jaw. Full breath in. Exhale, release the fingers. And full breath in. And exhale, releasing hips down to knees. Breathing in. And breathing out in this almost calm and zen-like space. We'll do just two more, progressing with our birth, arriving at the birthing center or the hospital, and all of a sudden doing the intake process of answering questions and pulling out your ID card and whatever registration needs to be done, and all the while experiencing contractions as you're being asked questions. And even in that state and even in that place, responding to it with full breath in. And exhale, release the shoulders. And full breath in. And exhale, release the jaw. Full breath in. And exhale, release the fingers. And full breath in. And exhale, release hips down to knees. Feeling yourself be calm, be open, body released. The last step that I'll take you through today is that infamous step of an internal check of how effaced is the cervix, how dilated are you. It doesn't last very long, but sometimes knowing that that check is happening can be enough to make us tighten up and tense up. And the more released we are, the more open we'll be, the easier our labor progresses or moves us to that birthing or delivery room that we've been waiting for. So breathing here, approaching that internal check, we take a full breath in and exhale, drop the shoulders. And again, breathing in. And exhale, drop the jaw. Breathing in. And exhale, release the fingers. And breathing in. And exhale, hips down to knees. Allowing yourself to stay in that state and plate of restfulness or place of restfulness. And what we practice today, these are basic physical relaxation techniques. This is like a foundation. but you can add to this foundation any other tool or technique that you find is helpful for you, whether that is a particular rhythm of breathing or a sound or a moaning or your birth partner or doula pressing certain places on your hips, on your low back, on your body. You can pair it and add to it and see what works for you. And the more that you practice this daily, multiple times a day, it could be 3 or 4 times a day, with yourself, with your partner, with your friend, with your child, with whoever it is, just releasing in a rhythm of 4 these body parts, the more natural, the more habitual it will be for you when it's time to finally go into that active birthing place and prepare to meet your baby. And this is something, this is a technique that's helpful in general, in life, your whole life, but especially in birth, where we need to release and open, this is gold. So let's try this together just 2 more times. Sitting here, we'll just call out the 4 different points, full breath in, and exhale, dropping the shoulders, and breathing in, and exhale, releasing the jaw. Breathing in, and exhale, release the fingers, and breathing in, and exhale, releasing away from your hips down toward your knees. Breathing in, and releasing shoulders, and breathing in, and releasing jaw. Breathing in, and releasing fingers, and breathing in, and releasing hips down toward our knees. If you have questions, if you have feedback, please leave them for me in the comments below. Definitely, this is something to explore, to practice, to enjoy. If you have time to continue to a few moments of relaxation now, please do so. Otherwise, thanks for joining me. The light in me sees and honors the light in each of you. And as we all enter this home stretch toward birth, just blessing all of us with an easeful, calming, opening labor and birth, and that our little ones should be healthy in our arms soon. Namaste.